Anthropology. You're back in session with Professor P. I hope all of you have been staying safe and healthy during this interesting time. Well, first off, I hope you guys are on your Canvas and on your Canvas course. I have it laid out so it should be an easy way to follow. I also have concept sheets in your Canvas course, so every chapter has the concept that you should be looking for and looking at. It makes it a lot easier. My students, especially in the classroom, they love the concept sheets, right? And it makes life a little bit easier. A little bit about me. My name is Leanna Padilla Wilson. I have been teaching anthropology at Las Madonas College for over 20 years. And I enjoy working with LMC students and staff and faculty. They always say we have to say something a little personal about myself. I've been married to my high school sweetheart for many years. I'm not going to tell you how many. We have three children, two teenage girls. I have an 18-year-old. I have a 16-year-old. And then my whoopsie blessing, an 8-year-old son. And sometimes you'll be hearing noises because my house can get a little chaotic with everybody here. But I want to start out with chapter one, sort of the introduction of anthropology. What is it? All right. Follow along in your concept sheet. Chapter one, it's really introducing what the field is. All right. It starts out with anthropos logos. Anthropos means man or human. Logos is the study of. Anthropology is defined as the study of man. The study of man in all aspects, whether it's biological or cultural. All right. What does it mean we're a holistic approach? Holistic approach means we study all aspects of man, right? All the W questions we answer. It doesn't matter where you're from. We study all peoples, all time period, all environment, right? And we study all topics related to man. Those W questions are what, where, who, when, and the biggie for anthropology, why. Okay, what's so awesome about this course is we're going to sort of travel around the world, right, looking at the various cultures and cultural and societies around the world. So let's start. What is anthropology? Anthropology has five main fields, okay, and I even number them for you on those concept sheets. The very first one is biological anthropology. Biological anthropology wants to analyze the biological and physical development of man. I teach biological anthropology. You could take biological anthropology at LMC. There's lots of subfields, right, in these fields, but there's three main subfields of biological anthropology, okay? One is paleontology, right? It studies sort of evolution by analyzing fossil remains, okay? So it looks at the big E. Sort of, and we look at it differently. This is not a field where we debate science and religion. We know religion is very important to people. We have a chapter on religion and magic in this course, right? People's identity, their values, right, are related to religious ideology. And we actually look at religions around the world as well. So when we look at it, we're not debating. We talk about evolution. We're just talking about changes over time, right? And that becomes important to sort of understand. The second subfield in biological anthropology is human variation. So wanting to sort of understand how and why people physically look different. Why are some of us shorter like me? Why are some of us taller, not like me? Why are some of us more stout? Why are some of us this? Why do some of us have darker skin or lighter skin or brown eyes or blue eyes? What are the advantages, right? What are the sort of maladaptive and adaptive traits that we have? But human variation really wants to look at the way we look. And it came out during a time of extreme racism to denote racism, to say the reason people look differently is because their ancestors were adapting to different environments. And it has to be for an advantage. People who have darker skin and more melanin, they were adapting in hot climates to prevent them from getting skin cancer. People who were taller were typically in hotter environments, right? So it's like a natural air conditioning system, right? They could sort of sweat, right? It becomes important to sort of understand these kinds of things. Another subfield is primatology, the study of non-human primates, right? Chimpanzees, apes, why do we go ahead and do that, right? We want to look at the similarities and differences in adaptation. All right, good. I hope you guys are following along. Archaeology is another field that I teach. You could take Introduction to Archaeology with me, and it really wants to look at using evidence, fossils, ecofacts, right, artifacts to really understand culture, right? It really is a cultural field where we want to sort of build a picture for you. You know, what were people doing? Why were they doing it? What were their cultures like, right? That becomes quite important. We look at it in terms of historical and prehistorical. So we divide it into those two categories. Historical archaeology is time where there was written record. Prehistory was as cultures existing time before writing, okay? And that becomes important. There's lots of subfields in archaeology, okay? Cultural anthropology, right? This could be the course that you're in. And cultural anthropology wants to sort of look at learned behavior, learned values, learned traditions that we acquire throughout a lifetime. And sometimes our cultures change, right? There's a lot of different concepts that we're going to learn about in the book. But one of the things they talk about, one of the concepts that's in the introductory chapter is sort of ethnography. Ethnography is a written description of the culture. It's a book, but it's all about culture ethnography. An ethnographer is me. Those are people who live with the people and they document their lifestyles and their cultures, right? Whether their gender, their marriage practices, religious ideologies, right? All these kinds of things. We also look at things like ethnohistory. Those are anthropologists who want to look at documents to understand culture. So their field work is going to be in libraries, government offices, right? So they look at all the writings about the culture and then they, you know, try to study and write about them. All right. Another section of anthropology is linguistics. It's the study of language, right? Just that, study of language. And there's lots of different subfields. We're going to talk about the three different subfields in this class. So we're going to look at like descriptive linguistics. We're going to look at sociolinguistics, right? We're going to look at historical linguistics. And we're really going to look at language being the fundamental aspect, right, of culture. The last one is applied anthropology. And applied anthropology is you have to sort of get some knowledge before you could understand that. But applied anthropology is using anthropological knowledge to help solve global social problems. It's really where we're applying our field. Things like forensic anthropology, medical anthropology, right? How do we help alleviate certain conditions like homelessness, right? All those kinds of things. What's the relevance of this field? We really want to understand people. We want to break down the barriers, right? We don't want to be ethnocentric, right? We want to be culturally relativistic, where we want to understand people adapting within their own environments and within their own opportunities, right? It's really to break down the barriers, right? And be more inclusive. Anthropology, you could utilize anywhere, working with people, right? Going to school with people. You could use it really in any setting to understand why are some people close talkers. Some of you guys have friends, they like are huggers and kissers. A lot of that has to do with their culture, right? You may walk inside somebody's, you know, house, take off their shoes before you go in, right? There's all of these different cultural traits and we're gonna talk about throughout the course of the semester, right? I'm so glad we met, and I'm so glad you're going to be taking this course. Anthropology is my passion. I love it. I can't wait to get to know you guys, right? Whether it's in the discussion boards, right, through email, through a Zoom session, and welcome to anthropology. I'm Professor P. Have a great day.